The wealthy owners of a Sydney patisserie chain have been charged with human trafficking. The husband and wife are accused of enslaving an immigrant, confiscating his passport and not paying the employee, who was also reliant on them for food.
It started as a fair trading investigation until it became apparent what was happening to a Pakistani immigrant was not just unfair, it was allegedly criminal.
Their freedoms are taken away and they're forced into situations like this.
Abid and Aisha Shah own The Cake Merchant, a string of successful patisseries in southwestern Sydney, and it was here, police allege, they all but enslaved a man to whom they had promised a good working life in Australia.
Excessive hours, their movements were restricted. They weren't able to have access to a bank account. They weren't paid for their time.
Federal police also allege the couple confiscated the man's passport and threatened him with deportation, despite the fact he was living in Australia legally, and that they would monitor his phone calls to family. Husband and wife have been charged with human trafficking and conducting a business involving the servitude of another. The investigation has been running for nearly 4 years.
Detectives that are involved have to work with the victims, ensure that they build trust and break down any barriers.
The Shah's home in ritzy Denham Court offers 7 bedrooms, 6 bathrooms, 6 car spaces and set on 1 hectare of resort-style living. We sought comment there this morning. No answer, while staff at their cake store said they can't be reached because they're off sick.
Since July, federal police have received 111 complaints about human trafficking. The definition of that extends to slavery, forced labour to pay off a debt, forced marriage and even organ harvesting. Investigations like these protect our most basic freedoms.
The Shahs were given bail. Their case returns to court next month. Robert Evadia, 7 News.
So in 2018, the AFP received a referral from the Fair Work Ombudsman that had an allegation that a person was being subject to some unfair working conditions in a cake shop in Western Sydney. So part of the allegation stated that this person was working excessive hours, their movements were restricted. They weren't able to have access to a bank account, they weren't paid for their time, and because they'd come in from another country, they were threatened with deportation, if they didn't work hard enough and, do everything they were told. I would describe it as, abhorrent. Taking advantage of the vulnerable, having people that, are coming to Australia with the promise of new opportunities, being able to settle into a new country, have a new life. A lot of the times, some of these people may have come from, countries where life's pretty tough. And, the fact that they've been giving all these promises and then coming into the country and being forced into these types of situations where all their freedoms are taken away, they're threatened with deportation, like in this instance, it's really terrible, and it's something that the AFP, works really hard to combat and look after these victims and give trust in the community that if there are people that are doing this, then we will bring the full force of the law against them and bring them to justice and make sure that they see their day in court. Unfortunately, we do see quite a bit of it. I think just in the last financial year, we had over 200 referrals, and then even this financial year alone, we've had over 100 referrals of people in the community that have been taken advantage of. They're being brought in similar situations like this where they're being promised opportunities and work, being able to be financially independent, but their freedoms are taken away and they're forced into situations like this where it's very difficult for them to come out of because they don't have those networks in the community in a lot of cases. Now, not every instance will be a police referral, but we do work with our partners with Anti-Slavery in Australia and the Red Cross, so that if there are instances that don't always come to a police investigation, we're able to work with these partners so that they can get the support they need. With the AFP, we have specialist teams of detectives that work in the human trafficking area. They're highly trained, highly committed to this, to crime type. With the global pandemic, Now opening up the borders, it's even more important to look for signs in the community of people that may be subject to these conditions. Now that we've got borders, people who are involved in this type of alleged offending will again unfortunately look for opportunities to take advantage of vulnerable people. For the community itself, these types of offending at times can be quite difficult to detect, but I guess some of the physical things to look for is people working long hours, starting in the early in the morning and then being there late at night, not having a lot of freedom, sort of being followed around by their employers. Other physical sort of traits they might have, they might be physically tired, they may have shows of physical signs of damage. They may be very timid and, depressed or upset with their current situation. But I think the important thing there is, if a member of the public, if you identify someone or have concerns about someone that may be subject to these terrible conditions, to please reach out to, Red Cross or Anti-Slavery Australia, or also the AFP. You can call us direct on 131 AFP. We'll be in a position to, help and support these people. With our partners, especially Red Cross and Anti-Slavery Australia, they can provide free advice and free legal advice, and also work with these victims through the process so that, they can get the justice and support they need.